Gamer Reflexes, You Noob, You Lose, Game Otaku, Button Mash. These names are great. All right, let's do this. Yoshikiri, the first ever NeoVision support unit and a completely dedicated one at that. His Trustmaster reward, Ceylon Shuriken, is a throwing weapon that boosts spirit and has a passive effect that boosts it even further. The spirit boost is excellent, but as of this video's release, no one other than Yoshikiri really wants a spirit-type throwing weapon. His Super Trustmaster reward, Spirit of the Shinobi, is a materia that boosts your unit's spirit by 80% and boosts it further so long as they're holding a weapon. It's a great spirit boosting passive that doesn't do anything else. So unless another incredible damage dealer like Sunwoo and King Long pops out of nowhere, it's not going to be first priority for anyone. Let's look at his active abilities. Yoshikiri's damaging abilities are magic attacks that deal physical damage which scales off his spirit. To make it simpler, think Wildcard Ace or Benevolent Beauty Rem, but with spirit. Alright, first up there is Throw. Oh my gosh, can you believe it? Throw? They're finally bringing back the Throw meta! Remember when Throw was such an important ability? S tier. Smoke Curtain is an incredible 50% physical mitigation buff that's balanced by the fact that it only lasts for one turn. After that, it becomes a decent 25% physical mitigation buff, though it still retains the 15% physical human mitigation buff. On the bright side, this is the highest physical human mitigation buff that we've got. On the other hand, that's just one race, and we don't have any insanely difficult trials featuring humans either. You Noob, You Lose is an incredible brave ability just for the name itself. The effect itself is pretty good as well, granting up to a 110% human killer for the rest of your team. Currently, the best way to get a powerful human killer is to use someone else's killer boost and spread it with Masterminds on. And while it's not exactly sustainable in long-term fights, it's not designed to be long-term to begin with. You're meant to grab the best killer available, say Zenaida's own 150% human killer, and spread that to the rest of your team and kill the enemy quickly. But what Yoshikiri lacks in burst, he makes up for with dedication. This is a physical and magical killer buff that can easily be sustained throughout the battle, though admittedly, it's only one type out of 10 killers or so. Chakra Purge cures all breaks for your team, and boosts all of their stats by 170%. That's rather low, though I probably set my expectations too high here. Regular team-wide stat buffs are actually lower than 170% on other units' active abilities. Ninpo Suiton adds the water element to another ally's attacks for 5 turns, imperils the enemy's water resistance by 80%, and increases your team's water resistance by 120% for 3 turns. Ninpo Hyoton is the same thing but for ice. The imperils are pretty underwhelming for a NeoVision, even by current 7-star standards. The elemental resistance boost, on the other hand, are pretty great, especially since these are regular active abilities. Finishing Combo is a decent Boating Shrike attack that fills up your team's limit burst gauges by a random amount, though overall it's perfectly fine. Let's look at his cooldown abilities. Hikikomori is a brave ability that's also a cooldown ability. It grants a team-wide barrier, makes your team resistant to breaks, stop, and charm, and activates Wombo Combo. Wombo Combo is a triple cast that's actually restricted. More on that later. Ninpo Bunshin lets Yoshikiri evade 5 attacks, lets your team evade 2 attacks, raises everyone's stats by an impressive 230%, and makes everyone resistant to breaks. The ability itself is excellent, though as its cooldown is longer than the ability's effect duration, you have to fill in the gaps yourself. Smoke Barrier is a ridiculous ability that requires Yoshikiri's limit burst gauge. It mitigates physical damage by 90% for one ally. Everyone else gets a 20% general mitigation buff. Is that a joke? Well, on the bright side, you can cast another, stronger general mitigation buff with another character without overriding the 90% physical mitigation buff. But that's really unimpressive for a NeoVision support character. Respawn requires half of Yoshikiri's limit burst gauge. It activates a re-raise for Yoshikiri and a weaker re-raise for the rest of your team. On the bright side, the turn duration is about equal to the ability's cooldown, so on paper you should be able to keep a re-raise on everyone easily. In practice though, it's rather common to expect your allies to die, be revived, and die again, due to the low regeneration. Well, hopefully that doesn't happen to you. Finally, his Magnus ability. Button Mash increases your team's limit burst damage by 50%. That's it? For the record, Tifa has a 150% Limit Burst damage boost on a normal active ability. I don't know who would appreciate this that would favor their Limit Burst over their active abilities. Let's look at his passives. So let go your aggro will boost Yoshikiri's elemental resistance by 50% for 3 turns when his health drops under the halfway mark. It also grants a 30% chance of dodging physical attacks and a 50% chance to not be targeted. But since this is a passive ability, it can be overridden by any provoke equipment, so feel free to use him as a regular evasion provoke tank. He has a decent physical killer against humans and machines, though it's not extremely impressive by any regard. Finally, his Limit Burst. Star Hurricane can deal physical damage that scales off spirit, cures any breaks, stop, and charm on your team, increases everyone's stats by an incredible 250%, and their elemental resistance by an impressive 85% for 5 turns. This is an excellent boost for your team, and there's no reason not to upgrade his Limit Burst if you have Yoshikiri. Now his Brave Shift. You can switch into this form anytime you'd like, though you have over a 2-turn cooldown. Wait, hold up. Why did his hair grow longer? Anyways, his Brave Shift has Throw. Wow, astounding! What would the player base have done if they robbed us of this godsend of an ability? Faint Block is the same as Smoke Curtain, though it raises your team's physical mitigation against machines instead of humans. Ninjutsu Jakuten is a Brave ability that's the same as You Noob, You Lose, though it grants a killer against machines instead of humans. Water Scroll is a much better water support ability that adds water to your entire team, boosts their water damage by 15%, and impairs the enemy's water resistance by 120%. Also, it chains with Boating Shrike. Ice Scroll is the same, but with ice. Ninjutsu Hakariyoku is finishing combo, though it has a burst hit at the end instead of even damage throughout the chain. He gets 2 new cooldown abilities. Champion's Mentality requires his entire Limit Burst gauge like Smoke Barrier. It reduces magical damage by 90% for a single ally for 1 turn, and grants a 20% general mitigation buff for everyone else. Game's Not Over requires half of his Limit Burst gauge and boosts one ally stats by 250%, and boosts Yoshikiri's own spirit stat by 300%. Finally, Ninjutsu Kaiho is a Magnus ability that makes up for Yoshikiri's previous underwhelming 50% Limit Burst damage boost by boosting it to a 150% team-wide Limit Burst damage boost. That's a much more impressive result, and units like Remake Cloud, Neo Vision Rain, and Red 13 will greatly appreciate the boost. His passive abilities don't go through any significant change from his Brave Shift. Finally, let's look at his Limit Burst. Killer Arts is a more aggressive support attack compared to Star Hurricane. It'll grant a human and machine killer to your team, boosts their Limit Burst damage by 50%, and raises the damage modifier of Yoshikiri's own attacks. So, how to build him? You don't need 2 separate setups for him in most regards. Feel free to boost his damage by raising his spirit, or build him as an evasion provoke tank. If you want to keep his passives in mind, he'd prefer to wear a robe and wield a single throwing weapon in both forms. In terms of Brave abilities, prioritize Hikikomori, as it raises the barrier health and the turn duration of Wombo combo. After that, do whatever you want with You Noob, You Lose, or Ninjutsu Jakuten, depending on the killer that you prefer. Before we end this reveal, I want to talk about Wombo Combo. Alright, the name itself is a party horse, but let's be real. Wombo Combo is a triple cast, but it doesn't include any of Yoshikiri's cooldown abilities other than Hikikomori. This isn't too severe of a penalty, as you can simply weave those abilities through his double cast as you wish. In the end, it's just a really strange restriction that exists for whatever reason. So how good is Yoshikiri? If you look at him, he feels underwhelming as a Neo Vision support character, even though he's perfectly fine in all regards. In most cases, he's better than expected with his multitude of buffs. Interestingly enough, his Brave Shift works against him, as his buffs are separated as a result. Well, in practice, that just means you want to change forms as often as you can to take advantage of all the buffs that you'd like to apply. But if you aren't thinking of specific scenarios, you usually just want to activate his Limit Burst in his first form, then stick with the other abilities in his Brave Shift. His damage isn't very relevant, though he was never marketed as a damage dealer to begin with. Keep in mind that you'd really like to bring someone else who can cover Yoshikiri's blind areas, or better general mitigation. He also lacks any sources of HP or MP recovery, so don't think of him as a replacement healer either. In the end, he's just a support unit. A perfectly decent character that's doomed to never stand in the spotlight. Thanks for watching, and if you like this video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. Comment below, do you plan to get Yoshikiri? We're not set to get a NeoVision support character anytime soon, unless the developers have a NeoVision Zargabath hiding away somewhere. For now, I plan to hold off on summoning Yoshikiri. I'd like to see what Starlight Elena has to offer before I spend any Lapis.